हरि ओम। वी शैल डू द चैंटिंग। ओम श्री परमात्मने नमः। ओम अथ सप्तमोऽध्यायः। श्री भगवान उवाच मय्यासक्तमनः पार्थ योगं युञ्जन्मदाश्रयः असंशयं समग्रं मां यथा ज्ञास्यसि तच्छृणु ज्ञानं तेहं सविज्ञानम् इदं वक्ष्याम्यशेषतः यज्ञात्वा नेह भूयोऽन्यत् ज्ञातव्यमवशिष्यते मनुष्याणां सहस्रेषु कश्चिद् यततिसिद्धये यततामपि सिद्धानां कश्चिन्मां वेत्ति तत्त्वतः भूमिरापो नलो वायुः खं मनो बुद्धिरेव च अहंकार इति यम्मे भिन्ना प्रकृतिरष्टधा अपरेयमितस्त्वन्यां प्रकृतिं विद्धि मे परां जीवभूतां महाबाहो ययेदं धार्यते जगत। So this seventh chapter begins by Bhagwan telling Arjuna that I will reveal my nature to you completely. I will tell you that by which you can know me completely without any doubt, both knowledge as well as the direct realization I will reveal to you, having known which, there will remain nothing more to be known. So out of millions of people, only few strive on this path of God realization. And out of those who strive, only rare few finally attain, come to realize God, Ishvara as He is. तत्वतः कश्चिन् माम तत्वतः वेत्ति। सो इट्स अ वेरी रेयर बट वेरी वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड अल्टीमेट अवर गोल ऑफ अवर ऑल अवर लाइफ टाइम्स। सो भगवान रिवील्स हिज नेचर थ्रू हिज टू फोल्ड प्रकृति। So Paraprakriti and Aparaprakriti. Through this twofold Prakriti, Bhagwan alone has manifested as this world. So His transcendental, unmanifest, supreme nature can be comprehended only through the manifested expression. So apara prakriti is there and para prakriti. So that para prakriti expresses as the Kshetrajna, as the inner self. Paraprakriti is actually that prana, prana shakti, associated with which Bhagwan alone is expressing as Kshetrajna. And through his aparashakti, Bhagwan is expressing as this world which go to form the bodies of all the beings, right from Brahmaji to all the devatas and all the other beings and human beings also. So Bhumi, Rapo, Nalo, Vayu, Kham, these are the five tanmatras. The cause of these tanmatras are the Ahankar Tattva. The cause of that Ahankar Tattva is Mahat Tattva. Cause of that is that Avyakta. This Avyakta is also called Bhagwan's that Maya Shakti. So from his power called Maya, first expression comes as Mahat Tattva. Mahat Tattva is like Buddhi, Samashti Buddhi. And in this Buddhi then appears Aham Pratyaya, which is Ahankar, cosmic Ahankar. And through that again further, the five Tanmatras, subtle five elements also are born. So this becomes the Upadhi of Brahmaji. So taking this Upadhi, Brahmaji further creates the bodies for all other beings, devatas, and birds, I mean the plants, animal, birds, human beings. So he keeps on doing that panchikaranam. So these five tanmatras, they are mixed together. One is mixed into another. That's called panchikarana. Akash is mixed with Vayu. So Vayu gets two qualities of its own and the quality of Akash also. Then this is further put into Agni. So Agni Tattva gets three qualities, its own and the qualities of Vayu and Akash. Then it is said, put into that Jala Tattva and finally into Prithvi Tattva. So Jala Tattva gets four qualities and Prithvi Tattva gets five. One its own and four belonging to other tattvas. If you look at this world, what we experience now is the gross five elements. The Akash element is infinite. Then the Vayu is limited. Lesser than Vayu is Agni. Lesser than Agni Tattva is Jala Tattva. And lesser than Jala Tattva is Prithvi Tattva. So this five gross physical elements becomes the body of the devatas also. Then they are further mixed together and they become the body of plants, and then they are further mixed to become the body of human beings, animals, birds, etc. So the details are given in our scriptures. So Bhagwan says, this is my prakriti, apara prakriti and para prakriti. Apara prakriti has got the samskar, or in it the vasanas of all the beings. Based on that, the world is created, the type of bodies and all. So, and these vasanas of all the beings are because of their avidya. So it is avidya yukta. Therefore the avyakta is called avidya sanyuktam avyaktam. It's associated with avidya. of all the beings. So based on that, the world gets created. And in this world itself, Bhagwan alone enters or is expressing as the Jivas, the Kshetradnya, or the Purusha. So this Jiva is associated with the Pranas and expresses as the individuals. In all the beings are this Jiva, which is nothing but, who is nothing but an Ishvara, who is expressing through his Parashakti called Pranas, is expressing as Kshetradnya or Jiva. So this alone is the entire creation. It's the expression of Bhagwan's Prakriti itself. Bhagwan himself transcends all this Prakriti, but is experienced through the Prakriti. So it is like something like our dream. In our dream, our own mind creates the dream world. And our own mind creates the person who is experiencing the dream also. So you might be sleeping in your room, but you experience that you are walking somewhere. So you create the world in your dream, and you create the body which walks, you create the senses which see, you create the mind which thinks in your dream. So you become the world, and you become the experience of the world through your own little power. In the same way, that Ishvara, who is Brahma, through his own power, he becomes the world and he becomes the experiencer of the world also. So at present, from our standpoint, when we look at it, the Kshetradnya, which is there, who is the Sakshi of this body, mind, intellect, is Ishvara. And this body, mind, intellect, etc., are the expression of the Ishvara Sapara Prakriti only. So that Sakshi or Kshetradnya is also called Purusha. And these are the parts of Prakriti. So Purusha as well as Prakriti are the Shaktis of Ishvara alone. So this is the structure, this is the way the whole thing is. So then, as the Kshetradnya, we have to realize ourselves as that Ishvara, as that Brahma. That is our sadhana. So Jiva Bhutam Mahabaho Yaya Idam Dharyate Jagat. So through his Prana Shakti, Parashakti, through which Bhagwan alone has become the Jiva, he holds the entire creation together and makes it function. Yaya Dharyate Jagat. So after telling about this Para and Apara Shakti or Prakriti, now further Bhagwan tells, sixth shloka we'll see. Etad yoni nibhutani sarvani tyupadharaya aham krishnasya jagatah prabhava pralayastatha etad yoni nibhutani Bhagwan says, etad yoni nibhutani, these two prakritis, para and apara, the ashtadha apara prakriti, and that para prakriti which is expressing as the Kshetradnya, and that apara prakriti expresses a kshetra. So kshetra kshetrajna lakshane prakriti are the yoni, the very source of all creation, of all beings. The entire the cosmos, the worlds, which includes all the beings, are expressions of Bhagavan's para and apara prakriti only. So the whole world which we experience is Ishvara alone is experienced as this world. Many people, they ask, okay, have you seen Ishvara? If you have seen the world, you have seen Ishvara. He alone is there as the Akash, Vayu, Agni, Jal, Prithvi. He alone is there as everything. This whole world is the expression of His Prakriti, which has undergone some modification. Because this Tanmatras are, they modify to become the Pancha Mahabhut. Then the Mahatattva modifies to become Ahankar and the our senses, organs of action, perception, antakarana. So they are modified. So in the modified, you find some sort of defect, some sort of shortcoming, which are not there in that Supreme. But still, their modification, their main cause or essence is that Supreme alone. Just as I gave the example of that mitti becoming apple. So in that apple, you don't find the qualities of this mitti directly. If you eat the mud, it won't be so tasty. But apple is tasty. But apple has come from there only. The material, see, it's a small little seed. It takes the whole material from the ground only. And that material itself converted into the beautiful tree with lots of branches and leaves, etc. And finally, we get the apple. From where? It's the modification of that mitti only. Similarly, this Ashtadha Prakriti are the expression of Bhagavan's that Shakti, Maya Shakti. And this further expresses as Pancha Mahabhut, Indriyas, Mana, Buddhi, Chitta, Ahankar, and all those things. So in them, we find a modified, transformed effect of the Moola Prakriti. It's like, to give an example of space, and from space, air has come. From air, what has come? Fire, then water, then earth, solid material thing. From that earth only we make a nice ghata, pot. So the pot is also modification of Akash only. But in pot, the qualities of Akash is not seen. Pot has got a fixed shape, it can change, it breaks, etc. But that Akash is all pervading, it doesn't have a particular form. But still, it is transformed into this pot. And again, that same space is present in the pot as a tiny little space. It appears as though it is limited within that pot. So Akash has become the pot and the space in the pot. You understand? In the same way, Ishvara has become the world and the Jiva in the world. Ishvara alone has become our body, our Upadhi, and the Kshetradni also. Kshetradni is also Ishvara, and Kshetra is also Ishvara. That we have to keep in mind. Therefore, Bhagavan says, etad yoni ni bhutani. This para apara prakriti is the yoni, is the very source, is the very cause, combination of them, of cause of all the beings. When I say myself as a being, there is the Kshetrajna, there is the Kshetra, and I have combined them. I am using this body, mind, intellect as my upadhis. I perform actions in this world, get result. This tiny little, that being which I am, is having the upadhi of this sthula sharir, which is made from prakriti, then sukshma sharir, made from prakriti, and I, also expression of Ishwaras. So, etad yoni nibhutani sarvanityupadharaya. See, when the scriptures are giving us this whole vision, we have to transform our vision and look at everything from this standpoint, from here. We might have our own ideas about ourselves. We might have our own ideas about the world, which are not accurate. So we have to transform our ideas, our vision, as per the vision given here. So, etad yoni nibhutani sarvani iti upadharaya. Bhagavan says, aham, because this prakriti belongs to me, there is no difference between prakriti and Ishvara. It's like Shakti is not different from the Shaktiman. Prakriti is not different from Ishvara. Just like, suppose we have some power, it is not different from the person. Similarly, the power of Ishvara is not different from Ishvara. So therefore he says that I alone am the source of this entire world. Aham krishnasya jagatah prabhavah. The entire world has come from me only. From my prakriti, that means which is not different from me. Therefore the whole world has come from me. Aham krishnasya jagatah prabhavah. I am the very source from where everything has come. And pralayastatha, and the entire world will ultimately merge into me. Everything will merge into me. See, in the field of science and also in various other thinkers and all, they give their own various ideas about how this world has come into being. But the ultimate thing is like this only. The world is a living entity. World is not a dead place. World is a living, and that living entity is Ishvara. So Ishvara alone is this world, and he alone is expressing in every part of this world. It's like our own body. We have trillions of cells in our body. Every cell is like a separate living entity, having their own mind, having their own way of functioning. But I am there. I pervade the entire my body. I pervade each and every cell of my body. The entire body is a living organism. If I take a little, tiny little portion of myself and try to see it under microscope and all, it might appear to be just an inert object, because life is not seen under a microscope. Similarly, we are seeing this whole cosmos. It might appear as though everything is inert, but it is not inert. Everything is controlled and governed by the prana, which is Bhagavan Shakti. Means it is, everything is governed by Bhagavan. He is pervading everything, every cell of this world. It's a living. We are living in a living world, not dead world. When we say Kshetra and Kshetrajna, Kshetra is also living. When we say body and I, body is alive. It is not a dead material. It is being given that life by me. So similarly, this whole entire cosmos is Ishvara himself expressing. So aham krishnasya jagatah prabhavah pralayastatha. So I am the source from where everything has come, and I am the one in whom everything merges back. In Upanishad also it is said, Sadeva Soumya Idam Agra Asit. Hey Soumya, oh my dear student, that before this world came into being, everything was Sat alone. That pure Sat, pure Brahma. From that Brahma alone, everything has come. So, Aham Krishnasya Jagataha Prabhava Pralayastatha. Further, Bhagwan says, Matta Parataram Nanyata Kinchidasti Dhananjaya Mai Sarvamidam Protam Sutre Manigana Iva Matta Parataram Nanyata Kinchidasti Dhananjaya. Bhagavan says, other than me, Mattaha, other than me, there is no other cause of this world. There is nothing other than me. No one other than me. Matta Parataram Na Anyad Kinchid Asti Dhananjaya. Hey Dhananjaya, that other than me, nothing is there. Neither superior to me, nor equal to me, nor lesser than me. Mattaha Parataram, superior, or Anyat, maybe equal, or Kinchit, lesser than me, nothing is there. I alone am there. Matta Parataram na Anyat Asti Kinchit Dhananjaya. Everything is Ishvara and Ishvara. Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma Siya Rama Mai Sabha Jagajani Vasudevas Sarvamiti. Like that, everywhere, same thing is said. He gives a beautiful example. He says, Mai Sarvam Idam Protam. Everything in this world is as though, Protam means, like when we do garland, no? We prepare a garland. Pirote hai. In English, I don't know what it is. Strung. Everything is strung together. In my eye as a string, everything in this world, all matter, all beings, all the worlds, all karmas, karma phalas, everything is strung into me like a garland is strung in a string. Mai sarvam idam protam sutre manigana iva. Like money, lots of pearls and all are strung together in a beautiful, with a thread. You can see the necklace, you can see the money. Many times you cannot see the thread. But all of them put together held together by the thread. If you remove the thread, the entire money will fall. Many times people do their japa and all, suddenly the thread comes. The whole money falls down, all the monies. Similarly, this one thread is there connecting every one of us. That is Ishvara. Outwardly, if we just look at the body, your body, my body seems to be different, is different. My mind, your mind is different. But within everyone and everything, there is this thread, this Ishvara, who is connecting everyone together, holding everyone together. So, Mai Sarvam Idam Protam Sutre Manigana Iva. Like the sutra holding all the manis of different colors, different shape, different size together. In the same way, Bhagwan is pervading everything and holding everything together. There is nothing other than Him. Brahma itself is called Ishvara. Itself is this world. Itself is all the beings. So as we come down this thing, we might feel the differences, we might think that everything is different, everyone is different. But as we go and understand our source, we will see the oneness. Like you fly above the Himalayas and the whole thing is clouded, and you can, above the clouds, sometimes you can see the peaks of those mountains. And all of them seem to be separated. But if you go deep, go down, you will see that all these peaks which might appear, which were appearing separate, are all connected within. Similarly, at the stage of with ignorance, when we look, I feel I am different, you are different, our bodies are different, world is different. But if we go deep, we will know that all of us are one only. There are no differences of any kind. So, mai sarvam idam protam sutre manigana iva. In order to help us understand this, Bhagwan, in the following few verses, he reveals his vibhutis, his identity, which we can recognize in and through this world. His vibhutis are being revealed now. Let us see. Raso hamapsu kaunteya prabhasmi shashi suryayo pranavas sarvavedeshu shabdakhe paurusham drushu. Rasohamapsu kaunteya shabdakhe paurusham drushu. Bhagavan says, rasaha aham apsu kaunteya. Hey Kaunteya, you understand that I am present in everything. He begins with water. He says that what you see as water, the essence of that water, the atma as though of that water, is the rasa. Rasa, the taste, is the nature of water. So Bhagavan says, I am expressing as the taste in water. In fact, I am like the taste. The taste is like a string in which the water is strung. Water is like a mani, and I am the rasa. So in me, that water is strung. See, for example, if you take a kapoor, camphor, not some film star, camphor, huh? If you take a camphor, good quality, huh? Original, not some duplicate material. So what is the quality of camphor? It is nice and soft. It is white. But what more? It has got a lovely fragrance. Thoda sa agar camphor le, nice fragrance is there. And if you leave the camphor alone, slowly it will keep on giving out fragrance. And finally it just disappears. That camphor disappears. Where did it go? It just disappeared in the air. How did it disappear? In the form of fragrance. So what does it mean? If you collect all those fragrance and collect them together, put them together, it will be that camphor. The camphor is nothing but fragrance solidified. So the essence of that camphor is the fragrance, which is seen in that particular shape, particular form. Similarly, the essence of water is rasa. That rasa alone is seen in that form of water. So that rasa, Bhagavan says, is myself. the dharma of that water is myself. I alone am there as rasa in water. See, this is a very beautiful. And for this, not only we have to intellectually understand this, but we have to feel it. That is where the feeling thing starts now. We have to feel the presence of Ishvara in each and everything. So when you drink water, the taste which we get is Ishvara alone. If somebody says that, oh, I have not experienced God, give him a cup of, glass of water. Even a tirtha is enough, thoda sa. That is God only. So, rasoham apsu kaunteya, he kaunteya, is pani me, mai rasa roop me mai hi hu. Prabhasmi shashi surya yoho. But everywhere he is not like rasa. If you look at the sun and the moon, God alone is there as light, as the brilliance. Or brilliance put together is alone is the sun. And that brilliance alone is expressing through the moon. So Bhagavan says the illumination, the brilliance which is there in the sun and in the moon is myself. So when we look at the sun, when we look at the moon, we should remember that through these eyes we are looking at God only. We are looking, God is not some concept, some imaginary being. He is very much alive, and through all our senses, constantly we are seeing Him only. Bhagwan ko aise jadugar ya ko aise chipe hue nahi hai. He is pragat through this, He is prakriti. So what we are experiencing is Ishvara alone. See, just like when we want to meet some person, we are meeting his body. Though that person is subtler than his body. When we meet some person, first we meet his body. Then as we talk to that person, we meet his mind. Then further we meet his intellect. We meet his chitta. He tells bachpan ki yaade vagere. So we meet his chitta. We meet that person's ahankar. But deep down below, if you go, is Ishvara alone. And Ishvara alone is expressing as all this. So, mai sarvam idam protam, rasoham apsu kaunteya, prabhasmi shashi surya yoho. So, when we look at the moon, beautiful moon rising, or in the sky, or when we look at the sun, sunrise, sunset, or bright sun, we are looking at Ishvara alone. Prabhasmi shashi surya yoho. Therefore, in our culture, we have this thing that we have to revere everything as Ishvara. We do namaskar to the sun, the moon, the mountain, the rivers, the animals, the birds, the plants. Everything is Ishvara alone. Sab kuch Ishvara hi hai. Sab kuch Ishvara hai. Just as the whole our body is myself, similarly, the entire world is the body of Ishvara. Again, in our scripture, he is also called the Ashtamurti Bhrut Deva, the Devata who is having the eight-fold expression like. So, rasoham apsu kaunteya prabhasmi shashi surya yoho. Pranavas sarva vedeshu. Bhagavan says, I am the pranava. Pranava means om. That sound om is Bhagavan only, who is there in the Vedas. See, the Vedas, if you look at the Vedas, so many, 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 many mantras are there. If you try to find out the sar of these mantras, they are there, the karma kanda is there, dharma as well as brahma jnana is given. But the essence of all these Vedas can be conveyed not only in small sentences, but even with one sound itself. Om. What are the Vedas telling us? Om. Who is God? Om. Who is the Jiva? Om. What is the world? Om. It's good. You can learn this. किसी ने कुछ प्रश्न पूछा ओम बिकॉज ओम इज द आंसर टू ऑल क्वेश्चंस रियली दैट अदर पर्सन डजन अंडरस्टैंड दैट इज दैट्स ऑल्सो ओम थ्रू दिस ओम भगवान्स नेचर इज इंडिकेटेड ओम एंड दैट साइलेंस भगवान अलोन इज एक्सप्रेसिंग एज द जीवा एज आई सेड एंड एज दिस वर्ल्ड. So I am experiencing myself, I am experiencing God only. I experience myself in the waking, in the dream, in the deep sleep, and ultimately as in Turiya, I am experiencing God. God is Om. In the waking, I experience only the aspect of it. In dream, U. In deep sleep, Ma. And in that Turiya, the silence. These are the expressions of God. So through that Om, I can recognize God within myself. Through that Om, I can recognize God in this world. So Bhagavan says, Sarva Vedeshu Aham, what you call Pranavaha. So Pranavas Sarva Vedeshu Shabda Khe, Khe means in Akash. I am Shabda Roop. See, just as all these five elements, they have their own nature, I said. So the nature of Akash is Shabda. Just as the nature of water is Rasa. So nature of Akash is Shabda. See, Shabda, we cannot hear when there is... Shabda is not transmitted if there is no air or something. But that origin of this Shabda, the guna of the Shabda, or the Shabda, that guna, comes from Akash only. Even the silence is a Shabda only. In that total space, you will only get silence. From that silence alone, all types of sound comes. So sound is the quality of Akash. And Bhagavan says, I am that Shabda in Khe. So in space, you know I am there as sound. In me as sound, that space is strung. And finally, Paurusham Shu. In all human beings, there is this Paurusha. Paurusha means that ability to do Purushartha. Paurusha in English, what will we say? A prowess, of ability. Because of which a Purusha is Purusha. So Bhagavan, Purushatva, Bhagavan says in all Purusha, that Purushatva is me only. If I am not there, then Purusha is not there. If Rasa is not there, then there is no water. If sound is not there, there is no space. If Om is not there, there is no Vedas. So I am the essence of all this. It might appear as though I have different nature, but I myself am expressing in all of them. See, rasoham apsu kaunteya prabhasmi shashi suryoho pranavas sarva vedeshu shabdakhe paurusham rishu. For again this whole shloka, one of the mahatmas, he looks at the whole shloka in a different way also. As a sadhana, Bhagavan is rasa roop. Rasa is also ananda. So we have to experience this Bhagavan as the rasa, param rasa, raso vaisaha, as that supreme happiness. So we should be able to see that God, So we, to see God as rasa, we have to use our mind and we have to use our senses. So Shashi is the devata of our mind and Surya is the devata of our eyes. So use your eyes and your mind to experience and experience God as rasa. But for that we need guidance. So guidance is given by the scriptures. So Om, the essence of the scriptures, we have to assimilate. That Om we have to hear, so the Shabda. And to attain this, we have to use our Purushartha, so that Paurusha. So using our Paurusha, you hear the sound Om, use your mind and your senses to do the sadhana and ultimately attain the experience of the rasa of God. This is just a different way of looking at it. But otherwise, Bhagwan alone is there in all the different facets of this entire creation. So these are his vibhutis. The same vibhuti, many more vibhutis will be told even in the 9th chapter also, and later on, elaborately in the 10th chapter. So he begins with his vibhutis from this chapter onwards. So some more vibhutis, chant the next verse. Punyo gandha prithivyancha tejaschasmi vibhavasau jivanam sarvabhuteshu tapaschasmi tapasvishu punyo gandha prithivyancha tejaschasmi. Bhagwan says the pure fragrance which is there on earth, which we some experience when it rains for the first time, then you get that pure fragrance of earth, or the fragrance of earth alone gets expressed through the various types of flowers. The variety of flowers which are there is very amazing, and the variety of fragrance which comes out. Even different types of our fruits, they have their own fragrance. So all this fragrance comes from this earth. So Bhagwan says, I am the fragrance in this earth. Punyo gandha prithivyancha. See, we can experience God through our tongue, through our eyes, through our ears, then through our nose also. Through all the five senses, we can experience God. That type of attitude, that type of bhava, we should bring and do our sadhana. That itself is our sadhana. In the 10th chapter, Arjuna, he asks a question to Bhagwan, again about this vibhuti. What are the various vibhutis on which I can meditate and realize you? There also Bhagwan gives a lot of vibhutis. So these vibhutis are meant for our sadhana also. So punyo gandha prithivyancha. Therefore, when we do a puja, we utilize all our faculties to do the puja. The idea is that you tune all your faculties to Ishvara. That is the idea behind puja. That your entire upadhis, the body, the mind, the senses, the karmendriyas, jnanendriyas, antakaran, everything should be directed towards Ishvara. So when we invoke, when we keep a beautiful murti in front of us, and then we do the puja, so all the five senses gets connected to it. Shabda, you ring the bell and all, chant some mantras. Shabda, sparsha, you touch. You offer flowers, you touch, you do the abhishek and all. So sense of touch, shabda, sparsha, rupa, you see the beautiful form of Bhagwan. Even while offering the flowers and all, you decorate you Bhagwan in a beautiful way. So shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa. Finally, we take the prasad, rasa, gandha, the agarbatti, and the, again the flowers and all. So shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. Then our mind, our feeling is involved. Our buddhi also understands that Bhagwan alone is expressing through this murti. Our chitta keeps on remembering Ishvara and his glories. Our ahankar, that I am the devotee of Bhagwan, that attitude. So our hands, our legs, everything is involved. Our vani, everything involved in Bhagwan's puja. So that is a beautiful sadhana. Puja is a beautiful sadhana to tune our upadis to God. So punyogandha prithivyancha. Prithvi is punyagandha, that is me. Tejas chasmi vibhavaso, and in agni, in fire also, that tej which is there. So fire is also quite an amazing thing. Fire is there in this wood, but now it is not expressing. So I can touch the wood. But if it starts expressing, you can see the tej, the brilliance, that heat, that light, that beauty, always moving upwards, having so many different types of flames, Kali, Karali, Manojavacha. Different types of flames come out. It's all Bhagwan's glory only. See, Bhagwan alone expressing from the subtle, he becomes gross. So first, the subtlest is Akash, we can't see, we can only hear. Then Vayu, we can't see, we can only feel the touch. The first expression of Bhagwan whom we can see is Agni. Therefore, Agni plays a very important role. Because we want to see God. So the simplest and the most natural expression of Ishvara is that Agni. Diya hum prajvalit karte hai. Bhagwan hi hai. He alone is there in front of us as that Agni. So tejascha asmi vibhavaso, in that Agni, vibhavaso, tejaha cha asmi, I am that tej, I am that brilliance. I am that light and heat. Then jivanam sarva bhuteshu. Then Bhagwan says, I am jivan in all the beings. There are so many variety of beings are there. Tiny beings are there in huge, like elephants and all. In the sea also huge creatures are there. Whales and all. Elephant, such a huge one. All the pythons, or different pakshis, so many different beings are there. All of them are alive. That para prakriti is expressing in them as life and as that being, as the sakshi, as kshetradnya. As kshetradnya. See, a tiny little bird is there in your garden, busy eating something. Then you slowly try to approach, then the bird looks at you. Who is looking at you? Through that eyes, the bird is looking at you, acknowledging your presence, recognizing also if you are there every day, recognizing you. So there is a seer in that bird who is looking at you. Then there is a seer in you who is looking at the bird. That seer is same. Bhagwan says, I am the seer in everyone. I am the kshetradnya. The kshetradnya is same in everyone. The mind is different, intellect is different, body is different. But kshetradnya is same. So jivanam sarvabhuteshu, that by which we are alive, that is Bhagwan only. That because of which we say we are alive. So sarvani jivanti, yena jivanti sarvani bhutani, that by which all the beings live, that is Ishvara's vibhuti only. So jivanam sarvabhuteshu, even this prithvi is alive. Some beings, they express only one of the senses, some express 2, 3, 4, 5. Some express only one of the antakarana chatushtaya, or none, or 1, 2, 3, 4. So the expression in different life forms is different. In a human life forms, we can express all our faculties. 5 karmendriyas, jnanendriyas, antakarana chatushtaya, all we can express. But if we get an animal body or a bird body, or a plant, we cannot express everything. But it is there, dormant. Even the animals, they have their own feelings. They are also quite humorous also, some of the animals. They want to crack jokes and all. We might not be able to understand, but they are quite funny. And nowadays with all this YouTube and this and that, people send funny videos and all, suddenly you see some animals real funny actually. I was seeing one video where one bird was making fun of a dog. Dog was tied and the bird used to go and pinch him on his, beak se karte na, kya bolte usko? Peck him on his tail. That fellow used to look, then again go, again peck him. So they have their own fun. So that life which is there in me and the life which is there. See that why it is called that life, prana is called parashakti, because it is untouched by avidya. It is not touched by avidya. Avidya doesn't touch it. In apara prakriti, avidya is there. Means avidya sanyuktam avyaktam. All the avidya of all the beings and all and their vasanas, they are kept in the heart of this apara prakriti, with the help of which it creates the world. But in para prakriti there is no avidya. In the para prakriti, Shuddha Brahma alone is expressing as kshetradnya. The kshetradnya in me, that I am Shuddha Brahma alone. There is no ashuddhi in it. There is no impurity of any kind. Even the pranas, they are not touched by avidya. The breathing is not touched by avidya. Our breathing gets affected by our emotions and all, but that breath itself, the prana itself, has got no avidya. So the life in a bird, life in an animal, life in human being is same. Their thoughts, their feelings might be different. So Bhagavan says, I am jivanam sarvabhuteshu. I am the jivan in all the beings. Life. And tapaschasmi tapasvishu. Bhagavan says that there are great tapasvis. And what is their greatness? Their tapas. Their austerity. And what is tapas? Ekagram. One of the lakshana of tapas is ekagrata, concentration. Ekagram tapa uchyate. And it is said through tapas we can achieve anything in this world. What is required is focus, concentration, attention. We can attain anything. We have the power. So when our senses, our mind, all our emotions, thoughts, they get focused towards one particular goal, then we get more energy and we are able to attain it. So even the Rakshasas of the old times, they knew about it. So they used to do tapas. Ravan also did tapas. Kumbhakarna did tapas. Vibhishana did tapas. So through tapas one can attain great things. So Bhagavan says, the tap in that tapasvi is my own vibhuti only. It is me. I am there. Tapascha asmi tapasvishu. I am the tapa in the tapasvi. If you remove that tapa, nothing is there then. So I am the essence of the tapasvi. So tapaschasmi tapasvishu. Further, Bhagavan says, His vibhutis, he continue. Bijam mam sarvabhutanam Vidhi partha sanatanam Buddhir buddhimatam asmi Tejas tejasvinamaham Bijam mam sarvabhutanam Bijam sarvabhutanam. Bhagavan says that sarvabhuta, different beings, all that variety of beings who are there, their bija, bija means the seed from where they have grown, from where all of them have come, that is myself only. I am the bija of all the beings. All the variety of beings, their source, if you go back, it is me alone. See, like for example, we look at the sun is there, and through the sun, billions and billions of rays are coming out. And each ray is separate, a beautiful ray comes out. And if you trace the source of that ray, you will reach the sun. Though all the rays are going into different directions, if you trace the source, you will reach the sun. Similarly, there are billions and billions of different life forms are there. If you trace their source, it's Ishvara alone. Go to the root, go to the essence, it's Ishvara. The variety of life forms is totally amazing. It's like a great magic show only. So many variety of beings. And no one must have seen all the variety of beings. Even to classify them and all, it becomes so difficult. So many varieties are there. Even if you take bacteria, there are different types of bacteria. If you send your blood for testing, they will give you all sorts of this. So many. And every day some new type of bacteria come. So bijam mam sarvabhutanam. And bij is such a, even a seed if you take, it's such a miracle. A tiny little seed. It has got in it, apple seed for example, tiny little. It has got packed in it all the information needed to create an apple tree, to create the flowers and the, what you call, the leaves and the branches and everything. Everything is there in that seed. Thoda sa, usko chaba ke kha sakte hum chahe to. But otherwise, it has got the information to create. You cannot duplicate the seed in the laboratory. And you put that seed, the seed will just grow and take all the material from there. It appears as the seed has disappeared, but the intelligence remains. It keeps on transforming the material into that beautiful plant and tree and the branches and such a beautiful thing. When we are also born, it's like a tiny little seed which grows to become all this with all these limbs and all. So Bhagavan says, I am the bija of all the beings. Human beings, even devatas. So bijam mam sarvabhutanam vidhi partha sanatanam. See, the worldly bija, when we see, it breaks up to become the tree. So is it that Bhagavan breaks up? He says, no, I am sanatana bija, eternal seed of all the beings. All variety of beings are always there, potentially. They are there. Though in different times, different life forms are seen existing on earth, but potentially all type of life forms are always there. Bhagavan is the very seed of all these life forms. So bijam mam sarva bhutanam vidhi partha sanatanam. Buddhir buddhi vatam asmi. Bhagwan says, I am the buddhi. That ability to think, that ability to distinguish, ability to understand, ability to take decision, it's all buddhi. See, in English, we call it mind or intellect. But it's buddhi we have. Mana, buddhi, chitta and ahankar. These are the four expressions of our antakkarana. Antakkarana is an inner instrument. Just as we have this instrument which look at the world outside, but whatever information we get from the world, it is processed within also. Constant processing happens within. Now all of you are sitting and listening to me, constantly your antakarana is processing the information. Some of them you must be just discarding. Ye to main janta hoon. Are ye to suna hai. Some of them you must be grasping more with more thing and keeping it. I want to remember this. So you must be making a special compartment in your chitta to store this. Chitta is a storage system which we have. Immense, interesting storage system, which has stored you all the things which you have experienced in this lifetime. And it has got samskars of all the experience which you had in past lifetimes. It's a tremendous storage system. See, sometimes you go to a huge library, you want to find a book in college library and all. You go to the librarian, you give the name of the book. The librarian just goes there and picks up the book and gives it to you. This is such an amazing thing. Kisi ki ghar mein itne sare kitabe hote, but if you ask them for some book, they cannot find it. Then they buy a new one and then the same day they find a copy also. Storage, oh, system humne banaya nahi. So our chitta is there which stores information, all our experiences and all. Then our ahankar is there, our sense of individuality which we have. So this antakkarana, in which we have this buddhi, buddhi has got the capacity to judge, to compare, to visualize, to comprehend, to distinguish. All so many capacity. So this buddhi, if we use it properly, buddhi can help us to recognize God ultimately. So Bhagavan says the buddhi in buddhimatam, those who are buddhiman, in them the buddhi is myself. I am the vibhuti. I am that buddhi in them. In the fourth chapter also we had seen that one who can see akarma in karma karmani akarma yah pashyet akarmani cha karma yah sa buddhiman manushyeshu, is buddhiman among all human beings. So similarly here also Bhagavan says, I am that buddhi in buddhimatam. So buddhir buddhimatam asmi tejasvi namaham. Then there are some who are tejasvi. Tejasvi means having a splendor, having a tej about them. See, when we follow a particular path, let us say we follow a path of dharma, we follow the path of satya, that also gives a tej to a person. Our convictions, our sense of right and wrong, our goal in life, all this gives us a sort of personality which expresses through the body also, through our way of dealing with the world, through the way we act and feel. It's our tej. Like even in animals you find such tej. Like some tiger is there, lion, they have their own tej. A tiger, when he walks, all the entire jungle, it stops even breathing sometimes. And they just, lion, a tiger is moving. Uska tej hai wo. चलता है स्टाइल से. इवन दैट लायन व्हेन ही वॉक्स ही स्टॉप्स एंड लुक्स बिहाइंड. इट्स कॉल्ड सिंहावलोकन. ही लुक्स बिहाइंड टू सी व्हाट इज हैपनिंग बिहाइंड एंड देन कंटिन्यूस फॉरवर्ड. सो उनका तेज है. इवन अमंग ह्यूमन बींग्स ऑल्सो सम तेज. एंड वैन वी डू समथिंग रॉन्ग और बैड और अधर्म और समथिंग, वो तेज पहले चले जाता है. देन पीपल ऑल्सो नोटिस, क्या हो गया, मुँह लटका हुआ क्यों है. इतना लटका हुआ क्यों है. सो तेज चले जाता है उनका. इलेक्शन में हार गए, तेज चले गया. पोस्ट से उनको निकाल दिया, तेज चले गया. सो तेज एक्चुअली इज वेरी डिफरेंट थिंग. सो अ पर्सन लाइक अ यंग सीकर इज देयर हु इज डूइंग तपस एंड ऑल, ही विल हैव दैट तेज. इन द गुड ओल्ड डेज इन अवर स्टोरीज ऑल्सो ऑफ पुराणास एंड ऑल वी फाइंड दैट तेजस्वी ब्राह्मण चाइल्ड लुकिंग एट दिस एंड समटाइम्स दे गिव आशीर्वाद ऑल्सो विथ फुल पावर एंड दे कर्स ऑल्सो विथ फुल पावर. So that tej which is there in beings, tejasvi people, Bhagwan says that is my vibhuti only, that is me, I am there. So tejas tejasvi namaham. So in this way all these vibhutis are Bhagwan alone, which we have to see his presence, we have to feel his presence, we have to get tuned to his presence. That is our sadhana. See, many people, they can only see Bhagwan's presence or they have tuned themselves to an image or a photograph and all. But these are his vibhutis. And we have to see Bhagwan's presence in and through everything. Not only in a particular murti, not only in a particular place. Bhagwan here doesn't give a list of all his tirthas and all. That I am there in only in Vrindavan or only in Haridwar or nothing like that. He says you can see anywhere. Some people they go abroad, they feel, oh, I'm abroad, what will I do? Bhagwan ko kahan dekhenge? Wahan par bhi if you look at the sun, the tej which is there is Bhagwan only. Now America mein hamare Indian, hamare Hindu, Hindu vagere kuch nahi. Bhagwan ek hi hai. And you can see his presence in the fire, in the sun, in the moon, on earth, everywhere. And that is where we have to, that is how we have to tune ourselves. So much so that you don't, should not have the need for a picture or a photograph or an image to worship God. That is the beginning. But later on, one should transcend all these images and all and worship that God who is present directly in front of us. In Narad Bhakti Sutra, Naradji defines that love. प्रेम भक्ति ही सेज सातु अस्मिन् परम प्रेम रूपा. ही यूजेज द वर्ड अस्मिन् फॉर भगवान. अस्मिन् मीन इन दिस. दिस मीन्स हु इज राइट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू, हु इज साक्षात देवता. इन दैट साक्षात देवता टू हैव सुप्रीम लव इज कॉल्ड भक्ति. सो फर्दर भगवान सेज बलम बलवताम अस्मि, बलम बलवताम चाहम, कामराग विवर्जितम, धर्मा विरुद्धो भूतेषु, कामोस्मि भरतर्षभ, बलम बलवताम चाहम, कामराग विवर्जितम. हाँ, बलम बलवताम अस्मि. भगवान सेज अमोंग दोज हु आर बलवान, स्ट्रांग, पावरफुल, दोज हु हैव स्ट्रेंथ. स्ट्रेंथ नॉट ओनली फिजिकल स्ट्रेंथ but emotional strength, intellectual strength, strength acquired through their sadhana, strength acquired by following the path of dharma, strength acquired by what you call observing mauna or telling the truth all the time. This one bala we get. Different types of bala are there. So that bala is required for us to do and to attain God. In the Upanishad it is said, Nayam Atma Balahinena Labhyaha. He says that those who are balaheen, those are weak, weak body, weak mind, weak in their expressions, such weak people, Bhagavan says, you cannot attain that God, should become balwan. Bala is not only in weightlifting and all, but we should do some chanting of Bhagavan's name and all. Bala. So, balam balavatam chaham. To balavano mein jo bal hai, Bhagavan main hi hoon. I am there. So, in our case also, in us, if we find some bala, some talent and all, we should know, recognize that that is Bhagavan only expressing in me. Kama raga vivarjitam. See, bala also are of different types, as I said. Then there are bala which comes through kama and raga also. Kama means when we have too much of desires or too much of attachment, that also gives some sort of bala. Bhagavan says, I am not that bala. That is not me. I am kama raga vivarjitam balam. Devoid of kama and raga. Kama is desire to obtain what I don't have. And raga is desire to enjoy what I have. Shankaracharya ji defines it like that. Ki kama cha ragascha, kama rago, kamaha trishna, asannikrishteshu, visheshu. That which is not there with me, I have that thirst to obtain it, thirst to acquire it. That is called kama. Many people, they have this. पहले देखते हैं हमारे घर में क्या नहीं है, अपने पास क्या नहीं, पूरा ध्यान उसी पर होता है. इफ ओनली आई हैड दिस, इट विल बी सो नाइस. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड काम. देन वी हैव लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स, पीपल हैव डिजायर टू एंजॉय देम, दे वांट टू होल्ड ऑन टू देम, देयर ओन थिंग्स, होल्ड ऑन टू देम, एंजॉय देम, दैट्स कॉल्ड राग. रंजना प्राप्तेषु विषयेषु, that which is already prapta, we have that attachment to them. So this kama raga vivarjitam balam, Bhagavan says, is me. Because when that desire and all this there, that also people become more balwan. If you tell them to do something useful, they will not be ready. But if they want to go to some cinema, if you tell, go, yeah, book ticket, book karlo, ye karo, karo, it becomes, chalo picnic ko jayenge, suddenly they become more alive, like. If you tell them to do some other thing, they thak gaya, I can't do anything. Office se bhi aa jate log, pare thake bhage, I can't even remove my shoes, will you help me, you know. But us samay kuch aise party mein jana hai, kuch aise dance mein jana hai, again they become fresh. Let me just take a bath and shower and come. And whole night they will dance and dance. So they get bala. Kahan se aagya? Kaam aur raag se aagya. Bhagavan says, oh bala mai nahi hoon. Kaam raag vivarjitam balam. This bal se you get the strength to follow the path of goodness. You get the strength to do your sadhana. You get the strength to meditate. You have the strength to do tapas. That strength is myself. So balam balavatamas chaham kama raga vivarjitam dharma viruddho bhuteshu kamosmi bharatarshabha. Does that mean that we should not have any kamana? Bhagavan says no. Kamana is also myself. But that kamana should be dharma aviruddha, should not be opposed to dharma. If your kamana, if your desires are in tune with dharma, the path of righteousness, then that is my own vibhuti only. That is also good. Because desires are not bad, but they should be in tune. Because desires are the force which takes me forward. If I don't have desires, I will just remain at one place. won't be any progress, won't be any evolution. But that kamna should be in tune with dharma. Then that is my vibhuti, he Bharat Arshabha. So in this way, Bhagwan enumerated lot of his vibhutis. More of them we'll see tomorrow. Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.